Guys, it's worth noting that nitro groups or nitrobenzene is often used as a precursor to get to aniline, okay? So remember that aniline is an amino group on a benzene ring. That's called an aniline molecule, okay? And nitro groups can be easily reduced to aniline. So as you can see, a reduction reaction would remove oxygens and add hydrogens and make aniline. Now, even though we're going to discuss this more in your amines chapter, I do want to go through it right now and just kind of clue you guys in to some of the most important reducing agents that can make this conversion happen. Now, the one we always want to start with and probably want to be our default whenever we think reduction is lithium aluminum hydride. And that's just because this is the most common reducing agent of all of organic chemistry. So, and it's also one of the strongest. So lithium aluminum hydride will absolutely get the job done and will absolutely turn a nitro group into aniline. But there are a few other types of reagents that can do the same thing that you also might see. So do you guys recognize H2 and a palladium catalyst? This also goes for a nickel or a platinum catalyst. These would be the reagents used in catalytic hydrogenation, okay? So I'm just gonna put here, these are the reagents for catalytic hydrogenation. And that will definitely reduce your nitro group to an aniline. Now, one that's actually really special, kind of important here, is tin 2 chloride in water, or what's also known as stannous chloride. Okay, this benzene's just gonna have to get written on because I don't have that much room, okay? Stannous chloride. Now, this one is particularly special here because we're gonna talk a little bit more about this later. This is actually your only chemoselective reducing agent. What does that mean? What it means is that by saying that it's chemoselective, what I'm saying is that it has a tendency to only reduce nitro groups and nothing else. It's like kind of talented at doing that. And it really doesn't like to reduce many other types of groups. So that's gonna be important when we have other groups that are vulnerable to reduction. Stannous chloride is a great choice because it really just hones in on the nitro groups and turns them into aniline, okay? Finally, really common reducing agents are either iron or zinc in the presence of HCl. You'll see this all the time. These reagents turn into strong reducing agents that will reduce a nitro group into aniline. So, you know, really the exact reducing agent that you're gonna wind up using the most is gonna probably be up to your professor more than anything else. But keep in mind, bear in mind that all these reagents could be used in some way or another to reduce a nitro group to an aniline. My personal favorite is gonna be the tin 2 chloride, the stannous chloride. And that's the one that I'm going to use the most often in this course because I know that it's chemoselective specifically for the nitro group, so it has very high yields of aniline when we use it. Okay, so let's move on to the next topic.